Hey guys, welcome to WP Xbox. This is Ashish, and in this video we'll do a side-by-side comparison of Nokia Asha 500, which is a red in color, and Nokia Asha 502, which is yellow in color in this video. And both the devices are more or less the same, except, you know, some of the hardware feature which is there and which is not there. And many of you would like to actually see it on side-by-side. Now, since most of the Indian stores don't have the actual devices on side by side, this video is going to help you. So if you know somebody who actually want to buy it and want to see both devices side by side, make sure he or she does see the video. So I'm going to share the videos, like the video, and, you know, tell as many as people whom you want who are looking or interested in the Asha series. So let's start with the rear part of the phones, which is actually, or where actually the most of the difference is available. Now let's start with the camera, which is the basic difference between the phone. Now this is a 5 megapixel camera. This is a 2 megapixel camera. It comes with LED flash, and there is no flash here. So Asha 502 and 503 made a difference by introducing a LED flash and a better camera compared to 500 and 501. So, and there's a price difference of only 1,000 rupees or 1,200 rupees between both the phones. So now, if you want to sell Asha 500 to somebody, he shouldn't be very much interested in the photography. He might look for a casual photography, but not really low light photography, or even a photography which is, you know, not very serious kind of stuff. So looking at it, you can figure out, you know, LED flash, it like flashes three times. It makes the picture quality much, much better compared to 500. Obviously, we'll do a complete review and you will get to know the picture quality also. But this is one of the major differences. Looking at the speakers, now 500 has the same kind of speaker which 501 had. So you can see this kind of structure here. And probably it might be a little better or a little not better. It depends on when the final review comes up. So there's a speaker part which you can see in here. Looking at the design part, 500 looks a little bigger compared to 502. And the rest of things are same, because if I give you a side-by-side comparison, you can actually see that 500 is a little bigger phone. It's a little thicker phone compared to 502. There's not much of difference in thickness. If I have to say, it's only 1 or 2 mm of difference in overall the size. Otherwise, both are same. You have audio jack, you have USB charging cable available on both the devices. So you can see the difference is really not great. Now you can see the dual shot part right here. You can see the dual shot casing here, so it makes it feels like the phone is, you know, is inside or already inside a case, and gives you a very nice feeling, a different kind of feeling which you get on both the phones. So there's not much of difference here. Exactly the same kind of technology is used in both the phones. Now I'm taking on the button side right now. So you can see the buttons on 500 are a little bit smaller compared to the 500, and it's almost aligned equally, except that the buttons are a little closer, the lock button a little closer to the volume knockers in 502, while in 500 bits it's a bit far away because compared to a size increase. I'm not sure why is it like that, but that's how it is. Now also, if I give you a this look, a different angle of view, you can see the buttons are already submerged inside it, and the amount of thickness that's coming out is almost the same, except this is little bigger. On the other sides, there's absolutely no difference. You can see that. And compared to 500 on the mic portion, you always know the mic is always at the bottom of the phone. You can see the 500 has a mic right here, while the 500 doesn't have mic here. But instead, if I can actually show you, there you go. That's the mic of 500. The mic is right here. So you might see a difference in call quality, but that should be marginally as well. You can see the thickness, the size is almost the same compared to the screen. Now there's a difference in the screen, if I have to say. Let me just get back to the same to you. Now you can see both the screens right here, 500 on my left, 502 on my right. You can see there is a difference. There's not much of difference actually. It's only a difference of, you know, which is much more clear. Now 502 looks much more broader here for some reason, while 500 doesn't look that broad. Seems some area, there's a minute difference in the area as well. the buttons are LCD transparent buttons, so capacitive buttons, sorry. So they're almost the same when it comes to the working part. Now, how does it look from inside? So if I have to open up 500, I will use the speaker portion and I'll just pull this out and we'll do the same. Instead of speaker portion, I have to use the camera portion right here in 502. So there you go. That's how it looks from the inside. You can see there's a separate section for the camera. The battery of 502 is a bit smaller, but it's also 200 mAh less compared to the battery of Nokia Asha 500. You can see the difference here. The camera is this much and you have a camera section here, dedicated one. And the micro SD are both on the two sides. We have the micro SD on both sides here and here, same. And the SIM is also same, except the battery difference. Now I can pull off the battery for you. So just let me take off the battery. There you go. Now this is where you see the difference between 500 and 502. You can see that most of the components of 50 is visible. Now it's not visible here. There's a reason for that, because there's a camera unit standing here and it covers those sections. Apart from that, there's not much of difference. There's a battery slot, there's a SIM slot, everything is almost the same stuff. You do have the speakers here, which has this button so that you can actually take off the case. You don't have that part. So looking at on a different angle, you can see it's almost the same here. The buttons arrangements are same. The hardware or the build quality of both the phones are same. I mean, you really cannot find a difference between them, so you don't have to worry much about that. Now I will do take a look in the casing part, because I found in the unboxing that 500 case was much better, and that's actually the case. I can actually fold the 502 case a lot more than I can do with the 500. So the casing of 500 comes out to be much better. It seems, that's my guess, that's a blind guess, that 500 build quality might be a little bit better than the 502, probably because some of the components are not there, and hence, you know, the investment has been made up somewhere else. So that sums up the 500 and the 502 comparison. It's almost same. Now those who want to know that the comparison, actual comparison, will do it later. This is just a side-by-side comparison. You can see the overall difference between the hardware when you look at it, not when you use it, but when you look at it, this is how it looks like. There's 500 on my left, 502 on my right, and you can see the difference in the hardware and how it looks from inside or from this angle also. You can see there's a bit of thickness available here. 500 is a bit thicker compared to the 502, but almost everything is same. So that's pretty much about the 500 and the 502 side-by-side comparison. And we'll do a detailed comparison in the review itself. We'll come with 500 and 502 detailed comparison, and we'll let you know the difference between the performance. Also, the 500 review is pending, so we'll come up within next week or so, and we'll do a comparison also. Do make sure to take a look at the unboxing of both the videos, which I'm linking right here. So thanks for watching, and do let me know your questions. And please do share this video with the people who are looking between 500 and 502 so they can subscribe to our channel. Make sure you do, and we get to talk more about both of the phones. So thanks for watching, and keep us posted.